Henry from Aaron. Briefly, what we do, we developed a hard tech technology, the solar kiosk combined with software, to bring efficiency in distribution in rural, semi-urban area, and refugee camps. So what we do is, on the kiosk, we bring low-cost connectivity, we do intrusive financial solutions, and we sell BTU virtual top-ups, all into one. So, to answer quickly your question, starting the company actually is the easiest part of building a business. I want you guys to understand that. You know, especially now in Rwanda, it takes 4 hours to register your company, and it's free. And I can tell you it's the best solution that I've seen so far. We operate in 3 countries, and this is the only place where it's free to register your company that I know of. And if I can elaborate a little bit further, the biggest challenge is not starting your company, it's to implement your company. Because you have to quickly find a way to be profitable. Because the number one reason why companies fail is they run out of money. Especially if you deal with innovation. You know, innovation, it's about adopting a new technology, so the customer has to be willing to adopt a new technology. So whatever you do, you know, you can find registering a company anywhere. You go to RDB, you know, if you have a partner, you register your company with your partner. You can even do it online. I think now when I started the company in 2013, you had to physically go there. But your biggest challenge is how quickly can you make your business profitable? And a lot of time, I'm going to end with this. Most companies fail 3 times before they build a successful company. 3 times. This is what you got to know. It's the hardest thing to do to build a company. 70 to 80% of companies fail. You have to understand, this is not an easy task. Most of you guys that's going to start a business, you know, will probably fail. The question is, are you rebound and get started again? Because if you quit, then you're guaranteed to fail.
Oh, amazing. And finally, you guys give a round of applause. Yeah, thank you. But before maybe he hands over the microphone, I would love to pose another one question, then he answers. You started your company. When did you start your company first? Before I pose the question, the main question.
This particular company, so I moved back to Rwanda in 2013. So I started the company in 2013 for this. But I've been in business for over 18 years.
Amazing. So which means you didn't start it from America, you didn't start it from any other country, but you started on your arrival in Rwanda?
Yeah, for this particular area of business, yes. But I have a business in the States. And just to give you an idea, I failed. For my first 8 years, I failed. You know, I did about 6 businesses, just kept failing. But I kept going.
Amazing. If we can give a lot of applause. Thank you very much. Hammer, you've been running a business for all those years. You've been into industrial business. You've been struggling, and you, as you said, you felt like quitting, but you couldn't. What was the motive behind that never let you quit?
Well, there's 2 things. If you quit, you know you'll never succeed, so I couldn't quit. The second thing is, well, quitting means that I would never know, I'll never know how to reach my full potential. I think as humans, we exceed when we're against the wall, when everything is against us, and then we have to make a decision. Do I continue and fight for it, or do I just quit and do whatever else there is available? For me personally, my belief is we only have one life. You only have one life to live. Why would I live in fear or in willingly quitting and all those things? My dream was to be in business. I tried to quit college a few times. I don't recommend anybody to do that. But I tried to quit university 3 times, you know, and my mom was very specific. if I quit, not to talk to her anymore. So I had to continue, but I always knew business was the way to go for me.
Amazing. Thank you so very much. Let's once again enjoy the moment, because if one makes a point, you have to appreciate it, because you will kind of get the money that is equivalent to the point given. Brother Henry, you've been running business for all this long, and you've combined the different resources. You've tried to gain the skills it takes for you to sustain your business. What is the projection of your business, and what do you want to see your business doing in that projection you are seeing in the future?
I mean, our goal is in the next 15 years, it's 20 countries in Africa, so that the technology was designed to be able to scale. Rwanda was more of a testing ground, but we believe that if you really want to build a bigger business, especially we have investors, so to show scalability, you have to grow outside the specific countries. So yeah, our goal is very simple, it's 20 countries in 15 years. We are a social impact enterprise. So our focus is not necessarily money, but it's primarily our social impact. But we are for profit. I hope that answers your question.
Imagine running a business, the priority number one in your business is not money, but it's social impact. Come on, can he do something that is related to what the sisters beside are doing? Amazing, thank you so very much. And as for us to finish, to finish this panel, would you just take 2 minutes and share with these young people who have turned up for this year's conference, first edition, how they can start their business and then it becomes successful?
I mean, it's 2 minutes. I believe there's 6 key things that you need to have or to do.
6 key things.
Yes.
Yes. Can you write 6?
6, in business. Number one, you have to get started. So you have to go register your business and get started. The second thing is you need to do a lot of networking. Especially I've seen in Rwanda, the youth don't network a lot. You know, we tend to stay in our own corners and all, but spend time networking. Rwanda has now a conference center. Try to attend events like this. Those are very important. The third thing is you need to strategize, and the fourth is execute. They go together. You know, strategize, execute. A lot of time your first strategy is not the right one, so you need to change it. Execute, test, until you have a winning formula. You know, that's very important. The other things you need to do is, if you plan to scale, look for funding. Because like I said, the one reason most businesses fail is because they run out of money. And then after that, it's problematic. And the last thing I would say is never quit. Never, ever, ever quit your dream. You know, it doesn't matter how hard it is. It doesn't matter how much challenges, because you're going to get a lot of challenges. Don't quit. Because as I said earlier, quit is no win. It's just that simple.
Amazing.
My question goes to Mr. Henry. I want to ask you that, just tell me, what are the challenges that you faced with in your business, and how comes that you came to solve them, and what is the purpose or the importance of your business to this generation that is coming, in order that if someone maybe is being convinced in your business, can just...
And be part of it?
Be part of it. Thank you.
As far as challenges, we don't have time for me to talk about all the challenges I go through. It's a lot. But I think To answer your question, any business goes through challenges, but you gotta solve your problem as they come. Don't try to figure out what is the challenge you're gonna have in 2 years or 3 years. You're just gonna create headaches for no reason. So whatever business you get started, you know, figure out what are your challenges and solve them as they come. One of the things you guys gonna learn is, and it varies, not everybody is interested in building a big business. Some of you guys just want a small business or localized business, which is fine. That's no problem with that. But if you're gonna build a bigger business, you're gonna realize that the bigger the business is, the more challenges and stress you're gonna get. Don't think because the business is big or the person is sitting and is chill, like they call it. So don't try to figure out what the challenge of tomorrow. Just solve your challenges as they come. But get started first, obviously.
Good point. Get started first.